Hello everyone, you join me today on the banks of the River Taff for a day's fishing with me obviously. I've set my gear up, I've got a 13 foot Kevin Ashurst float rod up. For all of you that know, that's a very old rod now. I've got my landing net set up, I haven't put any feed in yet at all. I haven't fished this river for about 30 years now, so it's an unknown quantity at the moment what I'm going to catch. There used to be nice dace and roach and chub in here. I understand there's barbel in, you know, to quite a good size. I've never caught a barbel, so that's going to be a bonus if I do catch one. I'm going to start off on a stick float. It's only 4 pound main line on it and a 3 pound bottom, so if I connect with a barbel, it's more than likely going to snap me up. Without any further ado, I'm going to start fishing. The float I'm using is a lignum float. It's a wooden type float. It takes 4 BB. It's got a nice dome top on it. It's got a size 14 hook on the line, which is it, and I'm using caster. Just caught up a sec, sorry folks. There we go, size 14 hook with a caster on it. You see that? Sorry. I've been fishing a couple of minutes ago and I haven't had no bites at the moment, so I'm just loose feeding casters. They have got some grown bait, so I may try that any time now. Okay folks, I've just fed in some Mark Pollard supercharged black grown bait. I'm also feeding in hemp loosely, and I'm going to continue with the casters on the hook and loose feeding casters. I haven't had nothing as yet, but I have been dragging the bottom, so I know I'm on the bottom. I've been picking up weed. So just hopeful now that something actually takes the hook. I might well have bombed out on this swim because although there's a good depth in front of me, sort of about 4.5, maybe 5 foot. As I say, I know I'm on the bottom because I'm dragging it, but looks like it shallows up very quickly, which is not what I wanted. I wanted it to be a nice steady peg. So it looks like I've just dropped in a deep hole. The river's a lovely colour, and I'd imagine if there's fish about, they will take the hook. So keep my fingers crossed and carry on. Looks like I have got a bit of company. There's the resident cormorant just going across the river. I don't know whether you can pick that up. No doubt will be putting the fish right down. He'll be chasing them about and they won't feed properly while he's around. So that's not a good sign. Well, the River Taff is a big river, it's a wide river too, and the fish could be literally anywhere. They may be across the other side of the river, or they could be 100 yards downstream where they feel happy. The idea of this is to loose feed and to draw the fish up to where you're fishing, but at the moment that doesn't appear to be working. See, the swim's not a bad, sorry, excuse me again, this swim is not a bad depth. Run about 4.5 foot deep, which is well deep enough to hold any type of shoal of fish. Fishing on the inside, it's nice and slow. It's a lovely colour to the water. At the moment they're not biting, and I've fed in a few casters now. I've been feeding in hemp. I put a few small nuggets of the Mac Pollard ground bait in. And I'm now fishing with red maggots. So could be just a waiting game, but in the meantime, it can be quite frustrating. Hey folks, I've just ducked into my first fish. I haven't got the foggiest what it is, I can't see it yet. It's trying to get right under my bank. Well folks, the first fish happens to be a pretty decent chub. Which I'm struggling to get up the bank. There's a fish. As you can see, that's at least an old chub. That's got to be 3.5 pushing 4 pound. But I'm showing you the best side. It's had a very nasty injury on the other side. On its gill rake, which is the other side of here, most of it is missing, so I don't know what that's from. I'll pop that in the net. Anyway, that's changed the things quite a bit. Quite pleased with that, to be honest with you. Especially after, and I wasn't expecting to catch anything at all, so obviously you can tell by the tone of my voice, I was quite excited about that. I would say I was pushing 3.5, maybe 4 pound in weight. See if there's any others. Hope you can hear me a bit better than previous videos. I have bought myself a little mic. It's connected to the side of my mobile phone, so hopefully you can pick my voice up a bit better. And it'll stop a lot of the background noise, which I've been picking up on some of my videos. Like I said, there's a nice colour to the water. I'll just pan you round now. And my swim is just down there at the end of my landing net. I'm fishing really close to the side, to be honest with you. I don't see any need to go any further out than where I am. So it's good depth of water, 4 foot plus, and I've shallowed up about a foot from when I first started fishing, because it was dragging bottom. And I've just picked up that chub. It was a bit of a battle. As I say, I have got a light line on, so hopefully I can get a couple more out of you. It's been a long time since I fished this river. Further on down from where I'm fishing today, years ago I did catch a few fish in an open match down here, and I ended up finishing third in the match, which was quite pleasing. But as I say, that's a long time ago now, and you do lose grasp of what's going on the rivers and where to fish them. But you know, that's the result, obviously. So let's see if we can catch a couple more. I think what I'll do is, this is standard practice when you're fishing anyways, I'll leave it for 5 minutes or so. So they haven't got anything going in over their head, like a float, weights, etc. And what I'm going to do now is just loose feed, basically. And carry on with the casters, flicking some hemp in and some ground bait. I did actually catch that fish on red maggots, but I've only got about a pint actually. I've got a pint of red maggots. I've got 2 pints of casters with me, so I have got more castings than red maggots. The theory is the better fish go for casters, but I found in the past that chub especially like red maggots. And so do most other fish as well, come to think of it. So I'll just keep feeding for a bit. If there's any more in action, I'll get back to you. Hello, folks. I like to say I'm not struggling, but that's not the case. I had the one fish, but probably I'd say 20 minutes has passed now, and there's been nothing shown any interest up to now since. I've tried the caster and the red maggot, but nothing's moving at the moment. I've been loose feeding, as I was before. Red maggots, casters, loose feeding balls of ground bait. But it's fairly dead, to be honest with you. Okay, everybody, what I've been doing now is I've been actually trying all different depths. I've shallowed it up 2 foot shallower than what the actual depth of the water is. I've actually shallowed it to half depth, but at the moment there's nothing feeding, not in front of me anyway. Could be the case of just having patience. Okay, folks, I'm in again at last. I don't know what this is either. But whatever they are, I'm going to take my time on them because I'm not getting a lot of fish anyway, so. Right, I've landed that one. Well, that's something everyone wants to see. That's a lovely little chub. Beautiful fish. Let's hope they start feeding a bit better now. Okay, note this now, the closer I get to the inside bank, I think it's a fairly small fish. Again, a couple of bucks. Usually it'll put away from the inside bank. So I'm just going to see if I can connect with anything. Okay, folks, it's completely dried up on this. I think there was a little tiny fish on the inside, yeah, really, and then there was a lot of them. But I couldn't connect with any of them. So, who's that? Okay, folks, it's completely dried up now. I think what it was on the very close to the bank, that is on the inside, was minnows. So what I'm actually going to do now, I've got a cord and barbel rod on. I've never fished for barbel in my life, but it's always the first time for everything, isn't it? So I've got the 12 foot barbel rod. I've got 10 pound breaking strain line on. I've made a twizzle loop on the end. I've got a banded 10 mil peloton on a size 14 hook, and I've got a grown bait feeder. And all I've done is I've got a Mark Pollard grown bait, plugged at one end, and I'm using the 6 mil pellets in between, and then plugged at the other end with ground bait. So I'll give it a try, see what happens.
I've plugged 4 feeders full of bait now. There's ground bait on one end, and I've got 6 millimeter pellets in the middle, and
so I don't know if you caught that then. This is the fourth batch of squirm feeders I put in with this 6 millimeter pellets in there, grown bait, plugged both ends, and I'm just waiting a couple of minutes literally, and then bring them back in so it spreads the bait round. Suppose if you think of it this way, the water is nice and coloured, so apparently barbel like that type of thing. Let's wait and see. Okay folks, I only had to go for about, say, 15 minutes at the barbel fishing. I know it's not a lot of time, but it's a patience thing, isn't it? You know, if you you can plug away like that. So I'm going to go back to where I caught a couple of fish now on the inside, see if there's anything else turned up. Okay folks, I'm afraid I'm going to have to sign out. Just saying, I'm going to have to sign out. I just had 2 fish, one small chub, and a chub about 4 pound. Nothing else since, and my battery's just about to run out, so that's all from me for today. If you like my videos, as before, press the like button. If you wish to subscribe, press the red button. And if you want to be notified of any up and coming videos, press the bell. With that, all have a good day's fishing wherever you're thinking about going, or if not, you just want to watch fishing, enjoy yourself, and goodbye for me.